Hello, friends. Welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and I hope you're all having a great time. SpaceX is getting ready for its next Starship launch, and they're aiming to increase the number of flights they do this year. They're looking at possibly doing 9 launches in total. The Federal Aviation Administration is working closely with SpaceX to make sure everything goes smoothly and to help them get their licenses faster. They had to do an environmental review of the launch site in Texas, where they plan to launch most of their Starship rockets. After completing the review, the FAA said they could do up to 5 launches a year from there. But now SpaceX wants to do even more launches, so they're asking the FAA to let them do more. Elon Musk says they're aiming to launch the next Starship rocket in early to mid-March. This time they're hoping it will reach orbit successfully. The FAA says that sounds like a reasonable timeline from a regulatory standpoint. SpaceX isn't the only company trying to launch rockets into space these days. There are a lot of new companies getting into the space game, and that means the FAA has a lot more work to do. They've had to increase their staff to keep up with the demand for licenses. Back in 1996, they only had 40 employees, but now they have over 140, and they're still looking to hire more. SpaceX wants to speed up its plans for sending its Starship rocket to Mars. The U.S. Department of the Air Force talked about SpaceX's plan for a new launch site in Cape Canaveral, Florida. This new site would use an old launch pad called SL-337. This launch pad has a lot of history. It was built back in the 1960s and was used for big rockets like the Saturn I and 1B, which helped take astronauts to the moon. Now, SpaceX wants to use it for Starship. SpaceX plans to change things at SL-337 to make it work for Starship. They might modify what's already there, use some of it again, or even tear it down and build something new. They need the space for Starship to take off and land safely. But that's not all. SpaceX also wants to build another launch pad for Starship at the Starbase site in Texas. Elon Musk recently talked about it, saying they're designing a new launch tower with something he calls robot chopsticks. These chopsticks would help catch the booster rocket after it's done its job and deliver the upper stage into space. Elon Musk said they're planning to do a lot of launches. They're even going to upgrade one tower while they're still using another one. So having 2 towers is really important for them. Right now, the pad at SLC-37 is used by United Launch Alliance, or ULA, for their Delta IV heavy rocket. But after ULA's final flight there, SpaceX wants to move in with their Starship. Before they can do that, though, there's a whole process they have to go through to make sure it's safe for the environment and the local area. The first step is an environmental review, where they'll look at how Starship launches and landings might affect the land, air, and water around SLC-37. In the meantime, ULA still has one more launch scheduled from SLC-37 in March. Once that's done, they'll start winding down operations there. Eventually, they'll hand the pad back over to the Space Force, which will then decide what to do with it. SpaceX is the top contender to take it over, but nothing's final yet. If SpaceX isn't able to use SLC-37, they have another option: building a brand new launch pad nearby called Space Launch Complex 50. This would be on undeveloped land north of SLC-37 and south of SpaceX's current Falcon 9 launch pad. Led by the U.S. Air Force, with help from NASA, the Federal Aviation Administration, and the U.S. Coast Guard, they're conducting what's called an Environmental Impact Statement, EIS. This statement has strict rules for considering how a project might harm its surroundings. NASA got worried about Starship's power, so SpaceX started building a tower at Kennedy Space Center's Launch Pad 39A. This pad is important because it's the only one SpaceX uses for human spaceflight. To support human launches, SpaceX is also building another tower nearby at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station's Space Launch Complex 40. The EIS process can take a long time. SpaceX was worried about this process when they wanted to launch from Texas. Next, there will be public meetings to discuss these options. The goal of the EIS is to improve U.S. space capabilities and build infrastructure for launching and landing spacecraft. They want to make sure the U.S. can launch military payloads into space when needed. They need a new launch site to make sure they can still get to space without losing their current ability to launch. They also want to use private companies like SpaceX to save money and make their space transportation better. Some people think government rules are slowing down companies like SpaceX. They've talked about this at a conference hosted by the Space Force. They want to find ways to speed things up and make sure the U.S. stays ahead in space technology. On the other hand, the International Space Station has been a monumental achievement in space exploration. Taking more than 25 years and 42 space launches to build at a cost of $150 billion. With its 108.5-meter length and 1,005 cubic meters of pressurized volume, the ISS has been a crucial platform for scientific research and international collaboration. However, as technology advances, there's an opportunity to replace the ISS with something even more capable. Several teams, including Vast Space, Axiom Space, Blue Origin, Sierra Space, Boeing, Redwire, and Voyager Space, are working on plans to build new space stations in low Earth orbit. One particularly ambitious project is Starlab, a collaboration between Voyager Space, SpaceX, and other companies and space agencies. Starlab aims to launch a new space station into LEO using SpaceX's Starship rocket. This would be a significant departure from the traditional method of assembling space stations piece by piece over multiple launches. Instead, Starlab plans to launch the entire station, or at least its first module, in a single mission targeting a 2028 launch date. The key to this ambitious plan is the capabilities of the Starship rocket. Unlike existing rockets, Starship is designed to carry much larger payloads, thanks to its spacious cargo section measuring 9 meters across internally. This means it can accommodate payloads measuring 8 or more meters across, providing ample space for a fully outfitted space station module. With its unprecedented cargo capacity, Starship can launch space stations that offer more than twice the useful space of the ISS. This opens up exciting possibilities for scientific research, commercial activities, and even space tourism. For example, Starlab could support microgravity research, advanced scientific discovery, and even serve as a platform for commercial ventures such as space manufacturing or hospitality. From an investment perspective, Starship's capabilities are driving down the cost of space launch while expanding the possibilities of what can be achieved in space. With the potential to launch large payloads in a single mission, companies like SpaceX and Voyager Space are revolutionizing space exploration and creating new opportunities for investors. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.